Welcome to Atlantic Dermatology, located in Wilmington, North Carolina. I'm Dr. Crane. I'm a board-certified dermatologist, and I'm here to talk about Tinea Capitis, or fungal infections of the scalp. Fungal infections of the scalp are relatively common, especially in younger kids, and often when they're playing in school, first, second, third graders, one kid will get it, next thing you know, it'll spread to another kid and it'll go right around the classroom. First signs that you'll commonly see are just scaly and flaky areas of the scalp. And some kids, these scaly and flaky areas will take over the scalp, and they'll even get bumps or lymph nodes behind their neck area, just along the back of the neck there. So if you see the scaliness plus the lymph nodes, you want to start thinking of Tinea Capitis or fungal infections of the scalp. The best thing to do is often see your dermatologist, and the dermatologist will take a look at the scaling in the scalp. They may or may not do a culture to see what type of fungus grows. That's sort of optional. But many times when you really know it's a fungus of the scalp, then they'll often put the kids on an antifungal medication. Grisia fulvin is one medication that's very commonly used, and often it's a couple teaspoons in the morning, couple teaspoons at night, and go on for a couple months with this medication, and that often clears the flaking, scaling. If it's the inflammatory type, it'll clear the big pus bumps that are coming up, and then the lymph nodes in the back of the neck will go down and everything will get back to normal. So if you're having a tough time with fungal infections of the scalp or Tinea Capitis, then see your dermatologist.